From a glittering diamond ring to a sunny fall wedding, Kelly Clarkson and Brandon Blackstock once seemed to have a true fairy tale romance. Lately, though, things have turned a little sour for the once picture-perfect couple. Here's what we know about their increasingly nasty split. Kelly Clarkson and Brandon Blackstock announced their engagement in December 2012, and Clarkson shouted her excitement from the social media rooftops, tweeting, "I'm engaged. I wanted y'all to know. Happiest night of my life last night. I am so lucky and am with the greatest man ever." The original American Idol winner then proudly showed off her huge engagement ring on news site Who Say. The post, which has since been deleted, featured a yellow canary diamond with white diamonds surrounding it, which Blackstock designed himself.
Honestly, we didn't actually have a conversation about it ever until he just proposed, and I was like, awesome, let's do it.
Fast forward 10 months to October 2013, and the two officially tied the knot. With an excited Clarkson sharing the big news on Twitter, Clarkson wrote, "I'm officially Mrs. Blackstock. We got married yesterday at Blackberry Farms in Tennessee, the most beautiful place ever." By June 2014, the couple became parents to a daughter named River Rose. They were blessed once more in April 2016 when they welcomed son Remington Alexander. So what went wrong? Keep watching to find out. Clarkson's divorce came as a surprise to fans, as she and Blackstock seemed pretty happy in the months leading up to their breakup. The first sign of trouble in paradise actually came when Clarkson filed for divorce in June 2020, almost 7 years after she and Blackstock tied the knot. The couple even managed to keep the split a secret for a whole week before the story went public. This news arrived in an Us Weekly article a few months after Clarkson gave her talk show audience a tour of the Montana ranch she and Blackstock shared with their children during the pandemic. On a March 2020 episode of The Kelly Clarkson Show, the host showed viewers shots of her now-estranged husband riding around on a horse, plus photos and videos of family time as they played in the snow. Clarkson worked from the cabin during the pandemic, chatting with celebrity guests virtually. She even had her kids pop in to say hi to stars like Justin Timberlake and Anna Kendrick.
"This is Rami. We were just watching Trolls, so this is Branch and this is Poppy."
Kelly Clarkson stayed pretty quiet about her personal life for a while in the wake of her divorce filing, but she somewhat addressed her split publicly for the first time via an epic clapback at a troll. The star couldn't hold her tongue on social media in August 2020, when a Twitter user referenced her breakup and suggested that her marriage didn't work out because she was too busy with her career. The snarky comment came after it was revealed that Clarkson would be sitting in for Simon Cowell as a guest judge on an episode of America's Got Talent, following his scary back injury. She wrote, "Wow, shaming a woman who has a great work ethic, is a great mom, and who steps up and fills in when a friend asks for a favor, because that's actually what good old country girls do. This can't be who you are deep down. I have more faith in your heart. Aim higher, please." Kelly Clarkson finally spoke about her divorce directly when she returned to work on The Kelly Clarkson Show in September 2020.
Let's just get this out of the way. 2020 has been a dumpster fire.
Well aware that her divorce was big news, she continued,
"Because as you probably know, 2020 has brought a lot of change also to my personal life. Definitely didn't see anything coming that came."
She went on to note that she wanted to maintain some level of privacy for the sake of her kids, adding, "What I'm dealing with is hard because it involves more than just my heart. It involves a lot of little hearts. We know the best thing here is to protect our children and their little hearts. I'm usually very open and I usually talk about everything. But in this case, I will talk a little bit here and there about how it affects me personally, but probably won't go too far into it because, you know, I'm a mama bear and my kids come first." Clarkson also got candid about her split on Today that same month, revealing her plans to open up more about what happened through new music.
"I don't think anyone, you know, expects it. You see yourself, you know, growing old with someone and then life, you know, has a different path."
In September 2020, Brandon Blackstock's dad, Narvel Blackstock, the former husband of country superstar Reba McEntire, filed a lawsuit against Clarkson. He accused the star of owing more than $1.4 million in unpaid commissions, in addition to the $1.9 million she had already paid to his management company, Starstruck Management Group. However, Clarkson countersued and alleged that the management company had violated the California Labor Code for, quote, "procuring, offering, promising, or attempting to procure employment or engagements without a license," which she felt meant the money owed shouldn't be paid. In October 2020, things got even messier in the courtroom when Clarkson accused Brandon, Narvel, and Starstruck Management Group of having defrauded her by charging her outlandish fees during her time with the team. Legal papers filed by Clarkson claimed her estranged husband and father-in-law's company acted fraudulently and provided illegal services. On top of that, Clarkson alleged that the company defrauded her out of millions of dollars. Brandon denied the allegations in legal documents and claimed that the company didn't owe Clarkson a penny. Amid the nasty ongoing legal battle with Brandon Blackstock and his dad, Clarkson got a little more candid about her divorce and how she'd been coping over the months that followed her filing. Speaking to Entertainment Tonight during her most in-depth divorce discussion so far, she doubled down on the fact she doesn't want to say too much for the sake of her children, but confirmed she'd been finding things difficult, telling a reporter, "I care 100% more about my children than I do anything else on this planet. So that's been the hard thing of like, yes, I'm willing to share my experience, and yes, it is the worst. I mean, the past few months have been horribly sad, but at the same time, I have to think, like what I say has a domino effect in other people's lives."
This is my favorite girl in the world.
The star also appeared determined to keep things civil, at least in the public sphere, when it came to speaking about her estranged husband, saying, "Nothing's wrong with anybody. It's just, it happens. And that's why there's nothing to hide about it, in that sense." Though Clarkson didn't take the chance to speak negatively about Brandon Blackstock in public, behind the scenes it seemed like it was a different story. As the messy courtroom battle over Starstruck Entertainment Group raged on, separate court documents pertaining to Clarkson and Blackstock's divorce revealed the truth about how they really felt about one another. Documents obtained by E! News in November 2020 stated that the couple's conflicts had increased, noting that they struggled with co-parenting because of trust issues. That same month, Clarkson obtained primary physical custody of River and Remington, keeping them in Los Angeles while Blackstock remained in Montana. The court developments also included a few rules for the parents, including the stipulation that neither would speak badly about the other to their kids. Also in November 2020, Blackstock filed legal documents that shed light on the former couple's financial situation in the wake of their split. TMZ claimed the music manager wanted a whopping $436,000 a month, $301,000 in spousal support, and $135,000 in child support. But he wasn't done asking for cash. Blackstock also reportedly asked for another $2 million from Clarkson to pay his attorneys and the ongoing divorce battle. Though things went a little quiet in Clarkson and Blackstock's divorce proceedings for a few months, more details became public knowledge again in July 2021. Clearly very much ready to move on from her marriage more than a year after filing for divorce, Clarkson and her lawyer asked for a separate trial to make her legally single while her divorce proceedings were still ongoing. In the documents, which were obtained by Us Weekly, Clarkson made it very clear there was no chance of a reconciliation and that counseling wouldn't work. The star added that she and her estranged husband want to start over and asked the judge that her request to become single be granted. She doubled down on her point that she was ready to put her marriage behind her a month later, filing to legally get her last name back to Clarkson. Clarkson appeared to make it clear that she had completely moved on from Brandon Blackstock a few days after her request to become legally single was revealed in July 2021. Clarkson headed to Walt Disney World in Florida with the two kids she shares with Blackstock, though he was nowhere to be found. Clarkson posted an adorable photo of them on vacation to her Instagram account on July 14, 2021, writing, "We had so much fun at Disney World. All the rides were amazing, but oh my gosh, y'all, Pandora and the Star Wars rides are where it's at. Thank you for a magical vacation, Disney." That same month, it was revealed that Blackstock hadn't gotten the full amount he wanted out of Clarkson when it came to spousal and child support, but he was hardly left out in the cold. The blast obtained legal documents showing that Clarkson was ordered to pay Blackstock $150,000 a month in spousal support, plus $45,000 a month in child support for their children, River and Remington. The settlement was kept out of the spotlight for around 3 months before it was made public, with the payouts reported to have started on April 1st, 2021. While that certainly sounds like a staggering amount of money to the average person, it's not going to set Clarkson back too much. The court documents also revealed her monthly earnings, confirming she makes an eye-watering $1.5 million every month from her many gigs. These endeavors include her hugely successful music career, being the host of The Kelly Clarkson Show, and appearing as a repeat judge on The Voice.
Oh my gosh, you just one-upped me on my own song!
Nah.
It seemed like Blackstock also wanted to make a big change amid his divorce from Clarkson. Documents obtained by Us Weekly in August 2021 revealed that Blackstock would be stepping back from the entertainment industry and his gig as Blake Shelton's manager. It was confirmed that Blackstock had been staying at the Montana ranch he and Clarkson once shared ever since their split, and that the father of four planned to become a full-time rancher. Quite the pivot from the glitzy life he used to live, rubbing shoulders with some of the biggest stars. The documents also indicated that Clarkson had wanted to sell the ranch because it was reportedly costing a whopping $81,000 a month. However, Clarkson's request to sell the property was denied because Blackstock needed it for his new line of work. That same month, a judge ruled that Clarkson would not be responsible for paying the huge ranch fees. Regardless, it was revealed she would temporarily continue to pay Blackstock the almost $200,000 in spousal and child support. A big win for Clarkson came later in August 2021. Brandon Blackstock attempted to contest the prenuptial agreement they both signed when they tied the knot. He also reportedly wanted the properties and the money she earned while they were married to be split between them. That could have resulted in the singer losing out on some serious cash, as Clarkson made millions of dollars since becoming Mrs. Blackstock. According to TMZ, the star was clearly thrilled to learn about the ruling in her favor. So thrilled, she screamed when she heard about it while filming The Voice alongside her fellow coaches Ariana Grande, John Legend, and Blackstock's former client, Blake Shelton. Clarkson reportedly had a small celebration on the set of the NBC singing competition. Another big win for the superstar? The ruling also meant that she was legally allowed to sell the Montana ranch that had become such a source of drama. Let's hope this is the last step in a long and increasingly messy road for these two, so they can focus more on being great co-parents to their kids. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.